I was really the only black hockey player on my team at all ages. So I would get called like just a big black guy, or what are you doing on the ice, go play basketball.
For me, when people look at me, they don't necessarily think, oh, you're black, right? So normally they think I'm white. And I kind of saw sides of people that I maybe didn't want to see because they didn't know who they were talking to.
Growing up, obviously it was never easy playing hockey or any sport that people didn't think I should be playing, whether it be lacrosse. They always thought I should be playing basketball or football and stuff like that.
People would lash out at Dane because of the color of his skin, which was tough to hear some of the things that he went through, especially playing lacrosse.
My name is Dane Smith, and I belong here.
It was important for me to speak my story.
You're black, you have to be good at basketball. You must be good at football because you're black. You play hockey and lacrosse, the two whitest sports.
It was pretty cool to see people be like, oh, I'm going through that too, and kind of talk to them through it.
Play what you want to play, be who you want to be.
And I think that was really important. And there's still a lot of awkward conversations that you had with past teammates that kind of reached out to you and be like, oh, I'm sorry for saying this and that, but it's things that need to be done.
I played with guys from every kind of background, and when you're in a locker room, it's a family and everybody deserves to be treated the same way.
When Black Lives Matter and all that was going on, we were able to kind of talk with guys and show them like, oh, like some things that may not resonate with you guys as being wrong. There's just different ways to look at things and to understand and to be more sensitive and really sit down and have those tough conversations.
As long as we're taking steps, obviously learning, and that's gonna be a crucial aspect for the NLL growing.
We do have a ways to go in diversifying our sport. It's a pretty white dominant sport.
We're trying our best, but I think we can still do more. But like society in general, we can all make positive steps, and I think the league is trying to do that, which is great.
I also created a program to kind of talk to kids about the importance of diversity and inclusion, not only in sport, but also just in everyday life.
If you could speak to any kids who are looking up to you, what would your message to them be?
Don't listen to anybody. You're gonna have people telling you you shouldn't be playing this or you shouldn't be doing this, but if you believe in yourself and you have your main goal, stick to it and work as hard as you can.